PM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Stella Nadoze. This one a blessing. I'm a daughter, blessing Nadoze.
Blessing, how are you?
We dey live for 45 Echue.
45 Echue?
We come here because of madness. She the mad and the mommy water spirit.
The enemy strike her with madness. She was brought here because of madness.
So this madness, this problem, don't stay since 2014.
Since 2014, how many years from now? 2 years, 2014, 2015, madness. But she was brought to OPM. Do you have the video when she was brought to OPM? Do you have the video? So how are you?
I'm fine, sir. I'm okay.
Kneel down. Amen. Madness of 2 years. Dr. Jesus did it here.
My name is Patience Umo. I'm from Akwa Ibom. I live at 22 Patterson at Ogudiago.
22 Patterson. For you to investigate whether the testimony is true or lie, because there are so many criminals that are going to pay people in Sokoto to share testimony. So you call the address so they can investigate. Continue.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for what God has done for me. As you see me, so I suffer for diabetes.
You suffer for diabetes?
Since 2001.
2001 diabetes, how many years? Oh, 15 years. Okay. Give Jesus a clap offering. 15 years diabetes.
So, I enter hospital, prayer house, everywhere.
I go hospital, I go prayer house. No way.
But when my brother called me, say, I should come to OPM. Whether I will come to OPM, I say, I will come. Say, I should buy coconut. I say, what do they want to do with coconut?
What would they do with coconut? See, I buy coconut. Why would I do coconut? Because a pastor on television said any church using coconut is occulting. Why would I buy coconut?
He said I should buy. Even if you buy one or two. I say okay, I will buy one because I don't have money. He said I buy the coconut. I say I don't have transport to come here. Say you go. Let me come in house. That you can let me come here. So on 29th of July, I come here.
Wait, 29th of July, last month. Give Jesus a clap offering. Last month, she came with coconut.
So after the prayer, they say people should carry the coconut and go chop with the children for us. So I carry go. That is 29:38. I break the coconut with my children at evening time. So when I sleep normally. I wake up normally. I don't, when before, I will pass urine, full bucket of custard. But that day.
Oh, before, from night till morning, you need full custard container.
Yes.
But as you took the coconut, what happened?
Instantly, I don't see again. Till today, I don't take my 10 naira.
Till today?
Till today, I don't take my 10 naira. Buy drugs, say, for diabetes. But before, every minute, every hour, I drink three times a day. But Dr. Jesus, come and see me through. I say, but all glory, honor, majesty, thanksgiving, ascribe to this God. In Jesus.
Give Jesus a clap of him. You see, I'm just the coconut. Because if God did not direct me to do that Holy Communion, will he perform miracle with it? Because it's God that directed, that's why miracles are happening. Nina.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
I am God Elevachi. I stand at UST gate. I want to.
You do what?
You reside.
Okay, you reside.
At UST gate.
At UST gate. Number what?
Number 26 Augusta Street.
Okay.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for his healing towards my life. When I located OPM, one of the sisters is here around here. He called me when I am a minister in the church which I worship before.
I'm a minister in the church I worked before. And somebody says, hey, come to OPM. I'm an usher in my church. Usher who? She's a minister.
For 13 years. And I went there with sickness.
You went there with sickness. And you have been there for 13 years with sickness.
This is the problem here.
This is the problem.
So, this thing was gushing water. This sickness.
This thing was gushing water for 13 years. Water. And I'm a minister. 13 years. In my former church. Why, if church cannot change, what do you do? I'm a minister. But here I was gushing water.
So on November last year. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So as the sister called me, I refused. I said, I can't leave my church because what I'm doing there, I can't leave. But he was pressing me, bring the anointing oil and apply. I said, well, we have our own anointing to apply also.
We have our own granite oil and palm oil to apply. There is anointing oil and there is palm oil.
So after that incident, I now in the night vision of November, I now come with her. That night vision, I saw people testifying so greatly. I have no money. And I'm worshiping there, I'm poor, I'm a beggar. So
I'm a beggar, I'm sick, and I'm a pastor. What am I ministering? Am I ministering sickness to people or poverty to people? Yes.
So as I come, I just collected 200 naira after the testimony. They said that they should come and pay tithe, and I collect the 200 naira in my pocket, and I went to the altar. I kneel down there, and I laid the hand in the altar. Instantly, the hand dried up.
Yes! Only the first day she came, she put her hand in the altar. The altar of God, the power here, dried it up. If church cannot change you, what do you do?
At that incident, I did not even ask, okay, let me go back to my church also. As I go back, they started telling me, I not tell them the testimony I have in OPM. They said it's the effect. Very soon now, the thing will also tear the way it also tear.
Jesus Christ.
Just leave that in. That's okay.
Wait, though. Is it people? Oh, it's your faith, though. The thing will still go back. Affliction. Anybody pray for affliction to come back to you, that affliction will go to that person. Are you seeing? She now went to her church and was sharing this money. I went to OPM to pay tithe and I dropped my hand and the thing dried up. They said, no, it's your faith. It's not there. It didn't receive your healing there. It's your faith. The thing will still come back again. What kind of prayer is that?
So after that, I decided to go back, but I cannot go back. What I did is that I bought the bangle and I wear it in my leg. I went to that church. As anything that hold me captive in this church, that I cannot leave this church and go, Dr. Jesus should lose me. And when they see me with that bangle, they say, what are you wearing in your leg? I say, it's Dr. Jesus. The assistant pastor asked me, I think that is OPM. We don't, come, remove it. I say, remove what? Is it not the same Jesus you are calling here, that you are calling in that place? Why are you?
If it not be the same,
it's God.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't know what my mission of wearing that thing. So after that day, I decided to come out from that church. Hallelujah. As I come out, on November, I testified. I think December I testified. That time daddy was not around. I testified in this altar. I said, I talk about my problem. Because my husband died since 2004. I was just managing with my children. Poverty. Before I will pay my house rent, I will beg and beg and beg. But today, as I located at OPM, even as I came in, things were tough. But as I stay, I will continue with the miracle of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because they said that it's magic. But God gave me
miracle. Oh, they said it's magic.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
So when I come, this year, I be able to pay my house rent without begging.
Wait, this year you paid your house without begging. Clap for Dr. Jesus. Remember, since the husband died, 30 years in Afuma church, for her to pay for rent, she will beg. Babayala, give me kobo. She will beg to pay house rent. But as she came to OPM, she's not up to 1 year in OPM. It's just how many months? Between November to now, how many months? And now, she's no longer begging to pay house rent. Give Jesus a clap offering. Admission. Okay, for your daughter. For your own. You won't go to school?
Yes.
Wonderful. You won't go to school?
Yes, Daddy. I want to go to school. I want to forward my education.
Give Jesus a clap offering. You see, once you come to OPM, your potential shall come out. 13 years, she didn't even think of going to school. She was even thinking of feeding, sickness and feeding. But now, she's thinking of going to school. She's thinking of paying her rent without begging anybody. Once you come to OPM, your story must change. Truly, God is here.
God is really here.
Honestly, God is here.
Truly, God is in OPM. I am a testimony and I am a witness.
Are you tired of being single? Are you tired of looking for a good job? Are people calling you barren woman? Do you need salvation? Dr. Jesus is the answer.
If church cannot change you, what do you do?
Change your church. Change your church. Change your church. Come this Sunday morning before 8 a.m. and God's General, Apostle Chibuzo, will attend to you and give you prayer assignment. And your story must change.
Please don't know when the role of this individual is over. The role this pastor played in my life is over. It is time for me to move to my next level.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here. God is here. God is here.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
Indeed, God is here. I just want to testify to the glory of God. My name is Goodness Chizoba Festus. And here is my daughter. For 3 years ago, 2010-11, I find out that my daughter had been stealing, and one day
she had been stealing since when?
3 years
now. Since 3 years, yeah. She had been stealing.
Yes.
Okay.
So she came back from school in 2010. She told me something that the school wants to do her queen of the school because of she's intelligent, very brilliant.
Okay, the school wants to make her the queen of the school because she's beautiful. Look at her, yes. She's a very beautiful girl and she's intelligent.
So uh-huh. When she come back, the following time she told me that they were in devotion, somebody gave her biscuits. After she eat the biscuit, something tell her that that bag there is money inside. She moved.
Are you seeing wickedness? Please watch me, teenagers and students. Please, if your parents did not give you biscuit or this thing, don't eat it. Don't eat. If it's not coming from your parents, because so many children, in fact, there is a child that was brought here. The child does not have diabetes, but after they gave him sweet toast, he leak in the school, he started having diabetes. Many people have been initiated into witchcraft just by eating something in the school. Imagine beautiful girl that they want to make queen of the school. Somebody gave her a biscuit. As that person gave her a biscuit, the evil spirit entered into her. Say, look at that person's bag. Open it. There is money inside. Uh-huh.
And when she opened the bag, she saw money. She now dropped the bag and ran away. Before you know, she started stealing my house. Before it was not so. I called her, I pray, I write a scripture for her. I pray we did night vigil. She was doing it only in our house. But reaching last year, I told one of her church women, she said, okay, that she's taking me somewhere. I said, I don't want to go because this is spiritual something. I don't want to go and put hand in another spiritual thing. I take it to God, I pray, I fast, I sow seed. In fact, I made up my mind. In our church, they selected 3 people to go to Ibuku Afternoon Road to go and open church. I joined them. I said, God, I want to challenge you. This is only my daughter, 3 boys. How will devil see this girl like this? I joined them. 2 years, we built the church, established church, cost more than 30 souls. We come back to the church. When we came back, it became worse. Now, this is not go from level. After the house, she go outside. When she's going, she says something, we whisper to her, come. Inside people's shop, people will be there, she enter. She will be packing their 5 naira, not even good money. 5 naira. When the thing left her, she will drop it and run away. The thing have been going.
Imagine that kind of disgrace. She will pick 5 naira, not even every arrow of disgrace. Targeted against you shall go back to the senders. What a disgrace. What a disgraceful arrow. To show you that this is not her. Something is pushing her to do it. Please continue. Uh-huh.
So, this Amen. I came back from market. She said, Mommy, take me to OPM.
Your daughter said, take me to OPM.
Yes.
That is when? May. How many months from now? 3 months from now. 4 months. 4 months. Take me to OPM. So how did she hear about OPM?
She's watching on television. Anytime she on television, she's put to OPM. She has called herself in line. When I called, she said, Mommy, take me to OPM. I said, okay, I will go. But in that church, I don't know. I don't know where it is. But when I pass it to go to Imo State, I will see OPM. But we ask. Daddy, we came there, night vigil.
My night vigil. Uh-huh.
Something happened. We buy coconut. We do not know people we are buying. I buy.
Oh, you don't know. You see people buy coconut. You buy.
I buy. So, immediately we get to that door. I came here around 5 o'clock. Immediately we came to the door. Something said, welcome to the restoration center. I look back, nobody talk to me. I drag my daughter. I begin to declare faith.
Oh, when you came in, so a voice said, welcome to the land of restoration. But when she looked back, she couldn't see the person saying that. God is here.
I was declaring, we were sitting down there, I thought that this is last bus stop. Because our teacher had told me to come and cheer. We went and cheer. That was when I know that this is spiritual. Because I've been flogging and looking for a body, I've been wounding and thinking that it's physical. That day the teacher said we should come to
cheer
at the pipeline. We should drop, call her. She will come and pick up daddy. We went there around 9 o'clock. Calling this woman at 2 o'clock, nobody not go. We were standing there knowing where we are going. When I told her, let's come back, immediately we enter Port Harcourt, the woman called us. Say, you did not come again. I said, you off your phone. She said, she did not off any phone. That is when I realized myself, I said, okay, therefore, this battle, I am going to win, you are going to lose.
Satan, I will win and you will lose.
My daughter has been a mockery, I don't want to go into a story. When we came, after that night vigil, we break the coconut, she wash her face, we eat. When we came, they not told her about assignment. We go, Sunday we came back. Wednesday we took assignment. I took the same thing, because it's a battle, it's a shame. I took the same thing with her. Daddy, we were doing it. Last month, when we were praying about the Holy Spirit, blood of Jesus, seven times. We were sitting down there, because before you know 6 o'clock, I'm here every Sunday. And he mentioned, you said, there is a child, there is somebody here that you hear stealing. The enemy injects you spirit of stealing. Your parents heard it. You yourself, you heard it. When my son, I look at her, she cannot hold herself. I cannot hold myself. I said, try and hold your hand, drink the blood of Jesus. Her hand was shaking all over her body. Me, I don't know. And, oh Jesus, since that day, there is no trace of that.
Since that day, no more stress of stealing.
No more. And this thing I've made, she cannot go alone. Anywhere she's going, I'm going with her, because she said she normally see a voice. If you not hear a voice, something will whisper to her. So I normally, she need not go anywhere without me. But since we started this mercy prayer, after the mercy prayer, she has been going now. She's learning computer. She's moving all over. Last week, she called me in the house. She said, Mommy, I know where daddy keep money, but I cannot take it. Hey, Jesus Christ. Is somebody that even I put my money in the locker, she will find a way to open it. And when she takes the money, she will not use it. She will use it and buy something for people. When you ask, she will tell you, Mommy, I take the money, sorry. And I will ask her, what is nothing, she will not tell you. I use and buy something for children. And another thing, this is what brought me. But God now Adjara.
What is it, Jara?
The same day, we were drinking that blood. He said, there is somebody here. You have a project, abandoned project. From now, that project will be finished. Daddy, there is something happening in my family, my husband's family. There is no building there. When they marry me to that family, I begin to ask them, I'm a Christian, born again. I said, what is happening? No good thing. When you labor, you go. 10 years, my husband told me that he wants to build a house. And when he came, the mother sister asked him for 500, give him. For 10 years, he forget the building. The house collapsed. So, 2011, we want to build. We have not told anybody. My mother sick and die. We scattered the money.
Check.
2013, we did not tell anybody. We just on our own. So yeah, let's go. My father-in-law died. We scattered that money.
Oh,
2014, we did not tell anybody. My mother-in-law died. We scattered that money. I begin to cry. I say, what is that? Is it that any time I go home, I will sleep in another person's house? Reading last year, I told my husband, I said, either I die or that man die. I'm going to be like my husband said, don't go. I don't want to lose you. I said, God, please, if you are not serious, stay back. I'm going to that village to build the house. And I will leave inside. Let me see that bagger. I did not even tell my pastor. This one is not a matter of pastor. I myself, I pray, I fast. I said, what I want you to do, just follow me, show me the place. I will lay foundation. And I will put that ferro inside that foundation, put block. And I went to the village. I mowed block. 50 bars of block. December, in the village, somebody came physically and called my husband's brother. He said, tell your brother to come and be laying foundation, not to scatter block.
Wonderful.
Yes,
came from the spirit. I said, this man, you get locked. I should have broke one of your legs so that you would not come here. The man did not concern my husband's family. January, I was angry. I went back to the village. I said, oh God, just show me the foundation. Go house. He showed me where to start the foundation. February, we started. Ending February, did he get to live there, daddy? When I came back, I was crying. Why did I go and start building? I did not know what happened to me. My financial, my business turned around. When I got to market, I will not sell. I said, hey, in fact, I forgot that I have a building. I have a project. My son will be asking mommy how about the fire. I said, please, hold down your project. I'm not doing it again. I said, please, hold that project. I'm not doing it again.
Check.
I will be crying. The little money I have, why did I go and start that kind of thing? I was regretting me that wanted to do it. I said, God, this December, I will leave inside. I was regretting. Daddy, that day, the same Sunday.
The same Sunday.
It was meant for me and my family.
Mm.
Daddy said, there is a family here. You have a bad project. I could not hold myself. I was sitting in the chair vibrating. When I reached house, Daddy, before that February, I was having money to pour the lintel, but that money scattered. I could not know how that 100,000 finished. But when I reached house, my husband called me. He said, I want to go and buy sand for the project. My husband was not here when he said that thing. But immediately I reached out. He called money, said, go and call the man to pour sand. I want to start the project. I said, God, he has started. And that is right now. We have started that. We are going to finish that project. Whether the devil likes it or not, it's a complete project. I just want to say, God, thank you, Jesus.
If church cannot change you, what do you do? For how many years? She couldn't get deliverance in her church. But thank God for OPM. She came to OPM and her problem is over. I prophesy. Because you have entered here, every problem you have disappeared in the name of Jesus. Kneel down.
It has been a shame throughout my primary school, my secondary school. I also want to give him glory because he has delivered me from this OPM.
Give Jesus a clap offering. Only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Say blood of Jesus three times. Are you seeing the reason why God brought OPM? Upon she, all the sacrifice she did, she even went, in order for her daughter to be delivered, she followed them to go and open a new branch. Build the branch, finish. Still nothing. Her seed could not bring result. But here, she didn't pay any money. It was just prayers. And God delivered her daughter. If you're watching me on television, I don't know why you're sitting on that cushion and smiling. Come to OPM so that your story will change. If church cannot change, what do you do?
There's no one like you, Jesus. There's no one like you in all the end.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You've just listened to the testimonies. You've listened to the message. You are next to testify in the name of Jesus. But if you're not born again, I can lead you to Christ right now. Can you just lead the way where you are? Lay on your skin. Let me pray with you. Repeat after me. Father Lord, I'm a sinner. I'm sorry. I promise not to go back to my old ways again in the name of Jesus. Now let me pray for you. Wonderful and great God, you said that if my people that I call my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, they will hear from heaven and I'll forgive and say, I heal the Lord. Heal the Lord of our children today in Jesus' name. Congratulations, you're not a new creature. All things have passed away and everything become new. Now, you can see me. You can come and pick assignment. You can come and see me by the grace of God. I'll give you assignment. The assignment is free. You're not paying any money. In fact, if you go to any church and the pastor says, before you see the pastor, you pay money, that pastor happens to be an armed robber. He's a thief. He's a rogue. There is nowhere the Bible says, before you see any man of God, you pay money or you fill form or you do this express. So you can come and see me and I'll give you assignment and your story must change in the name of Jesus. So call me on this number and Dr. Jesus shall meet you at the point of your need in Jesus' name.
Through
Truly, God is here.
God is really here.
Honestly, God is here.
Truly, God is in OPM. I am a testimony and I am a witness.
Are you tired of being single? Are you tired of looking for a good job? Are people calling you barren woman? Do you need salvation? Dr. Jesus is the answer.
If church cannot change you, what do you do?
Change your church. Change your church. Change your church. Come this Sunday morning before 8 a.m. and God's General, Apostle Chibuzo, will attend to you and give you prayer assignment, and your story must change.
Please don't know when the role of this individual is over. The role this pastor played in my life is over. It is time for me to move to my next level.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here. God is here. God.